Hi and welcome to this video. If you're new to the art journaling mixed media community, you might not know what a magazine harvesting thing is. And I didn't either before I started watching YouTube videos about collage artists cutting up magazines and harvesting them for good imagery and colors and maybe even some textures to cut out and save for collage, art journaling, gluing stuff down in notebooks, or even doing postcards that you can send to people. There are so many ideas. You can even cut out images that you keep in like a folder of inspiration. For instance, I've got one of these big binders where I keep interior design stuff which inspire me. Sometimes it's like a room or a color combination or something like that that I want to keep. So that's an idea for saving images in case you have a stack of magazines and you want to get rid of them and just save the good bits. So that's what we're doing today. I bought these at a secondhand shop here in Sweden where I live. We have magazines in Swedish, let me just say that, but of course it's always more interesting to find magazines in other languages, but it's always more fun to just find images in magazines that you haven't read yourself, and I definitely don't read Country Life. But these are recent ones, so from someone has a subscription for this magazine. These are from last year, just so they're not really old. And I picked four that has really cute animals on the covers, puppies and some dogs. So that's what we're doing today. I haven't even looked at them, so I don't know how long this video will be. I will just start with one and see how long we go and how it feels after a while to see how long this video will become. I have my scissors, I have some coffee, and I hope you want to join me to see if I can find something fun in this magazine. So let's just start and see. I might go through it again later, so if you see something that I missed, just let me know and I will go back and cut it out. But you can just start to look at it if you're interested in houses and beautiful gardens. This could go into my book of greenery, but I'll just cut out my favorite bits today if I find something. I don't really have a goal, and I definitely am not making a page of houses like the one I have in my Unmasked glue book, where I have a whole spread of houses and stuff. So this is the life. Is it yours? So cutting that out for something. Oh my god, these are not so much fun to look at. I don't know. I didn't know there was going to be so many ads. Love where you live. I like that sentiment. also like this sliver of color. So I'm going to save that as well as this. That could go into an art journal, but it could also go into the book I just showed you of. Interior design inspiration that I started that many years ago, and I haven't really filled it much lately. I guess I'm not really into that as much. Some horses and a dog painting. I'm really feeling the countryside in these, but really interested in the imagery. Maybe my picking of this was not a good idea. I have some Swedish magazines as well in a pile, so let me know below if you want to see me do a... Oh, I like this one. Chinese ceramics. Love this image. So, definitely saving it. I think this, I don't know where I would use it, but you could cut out them individually. And I also like these kind of sculptures for doodling. Just to copy the forms and such, because they're inspirational and fun to me. This little painting I like. So, is this where it's starting? So all this is just not in even the magazine, I don't know. That feels strange to me. Very autumn-y color. I like this one. Oh, and a map. I always like maps. And tiny little animals. You would just wish these two were bigger. So let's see. I'll just pull out this. Maybe not for right now since it's spring, but maybe for autumn. An autumn spread later on. This as well, it's really beautiful. So I often feel like I'm really too eager to stop and do the trimming on each of my images like that. So I often just chop them out, and then I have a pile that I can work further with later on. So saving the map. Cute little mice, but yeah. I don't even think you can see them, can you? They're so tiny! Oh, this is actually a dog. Yes! So cute! store, mamas. I'll cut them out later on. I like to cut out things like this as well. This is about October and a quote from Anne of Green Gables. Really good book. This could go into like my diary if it's October. And I find it, I could just use it as a little bit of decoration on a page. Little snippet of something. Riddle me this. It stands on one leg but never moves. It wears a cap but never takes it off. What is it? Oh, I have no idea, and I don't like riddles. You can tell me below if you know. Oh, I see. Yeah, let's see if any one of you knows that riddle. I like these, and I will cut them out for the colors. And I will cut this out because it is beautiful, and I am so longing for summer right now. This could be a Swedish meadow. But it's probably somewhere in the UK. But that's okay. We're quite close in. Oh, I like those. But all the cute images are so tiny. So I won't even bother, I think. Or will I? We have arrived for the cover article, I guess, which is about the Welsh Springer. So, typically my luck, the big image will have to go in favor of getting all of these. Maybe I could cut them out. Just have the dogs and not the guy. This is cute. I love that dog. So let's see what we can get out of this. I think my first glue book when I was a kid was about dogs. I never had a dog of my own, but I really wanted one. And filled a whole book with clippings about, a whole book of clippings about dogs. But there are lots of horses in this as well. Maybe I will give those to my friend who likes to ride horses. I don't know if she wants a whole book about horses. I don't think she's into that, but maybe. But this little fellow who's interested in the fika, he's going to be going into the pile. About an adventurer girl who has been snorkeling. Should I get this? I don't know. It's like a cluster of white and brown. Can't really see the dogs. Let's keep going. Plates of class. Bladesmith, oh. Hand makes both decorative and practical knives or weaponry. My boyfriend will want to read this. He found a niche I didn't even know existed on YouTube with people making stuff in making knives and swords and all kinds of crazy stuff, so I'm saving that for him. Another beautiful scenery. And a dog. Almost cut his head off. Yeah, oh my goodness. That is a room that is filled with furniture. I like the flowers of this one. Could be a nice background perhaps. I should just grab this one as well. Another dog, actually two, but he's almost invisible there. Let's go outside. Short days of autumn. Fussy cut that out later on. Oh, I think this is a problem as well for me. Either the image is too small, or it's way too big for any of my glue books and stuff. But the good thing with something like this, or this, oh my goodness, is that you can use smaller parts of it. It's great for doing backgrounds or using in art, because you can pick pieces that are just the color and you feel nature, but you don't actually know what photo it came from, so you can distort it like that. You can also use papers like this to paint on, to have it like a background. I have a whole pile to my side here from another magazine that is like that, where I just pulled all of the pages out for the color, not for the images, in fact. So this is going into my book of greenery. All these pots will be perfect for that glue book. If you go to my channel and click the playlist for glue books, you'll find two videos. It's gonna be cutting these dogs out. Oh! Yeah, nothing of importance. It's a really good habit to always check both sides of the pages, I think. But sometimes you just get into the cutting. No need for a cherub or pool in paradise. I'd rather be there than cut it out. So, more dogs. Don't forget to write home. The woman who made Vincent van Gogh famous. I think I'll read that one. So that's that. I think the haul or the harvest from this magazine was quite nice. Mostly dog images, but you could almost tell by the cover. Some nature images, not much color, which is what I prefer to cut out. I love colors so much, and these are very much in the nature colors of browns and such, but I think you need all the things, and it's just an experiment to get these magazines. I will look at some more in my next video, I guess, because we're already made a long video, so I'm just gonna be sorting through these. yeah, so that's my pile. Some words and lots of dogs. I'm happy with it. I hope you got something out of watching this crazy video, and that you will be clicking the thumbs up and letting me know if you want more videos like this one, because they're easy to do and I need to get through the rest of the pile of magazines that I've got already. So just let me know. Thank you so much for watching, and maybe becoming a subscriber. So bye for now.